Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we have free mulch. Yesterday morning, we were awakened by the sounds of somebody chopping down a tree, actually cutting down a tree. And sure enough, neighbors three houses down were having several large trees cut in their backyard. Well, before I knew it, while I was making breakfast, my husband was down there talking to the trimmers and asking what they were doing with the mulch. Once he found out it was not a willow tree, he said, "Bring it on up." So they did. They brought us two large truckfuls of beautifully chipped, I believe, maple trees.
Yep.
And we've been spreading it ever since. So the piles have gone down, but the landscaping is looking great, and the weeds, yay, they're going to suffocate. They're not going to get sun, and they're not going to be coming up through here for a couple years anyway.
Well, these piles were as high as the top wire on our grape arbor, and there were two piles. And so we were dismantling the first pile partly before they started bringing in the second truck, and then I noticed this morning they just dropped off a tiny little bit.
Well, it started raining yesterday afternoon, wouldn't you know it, so they stopped and we stopped, and we knew we had a little bit left, so this morning was the very end of what they had from yesterday afternoon. Now they're still over there. I don't hear anything going on over there, so they must just be raking and cleaning up.
Well, I can see on their first truck that's just filled with the big logs from that maple tree, so they're probably just gathering up the logs at this point.
Right. They asked if we wanted the logs, but seeing as our past history has not been good with cut wooden fences, we appreciatively declined.
Well, the city decided they were going to fine us $5,000 a day if we didn't move our wood.
That was in the front.
Yeah.
They didn't like our front fence, so we don't have a need or any space to put the wood, so we can't use it.
Well, let's take a quick look at what you've been able to do with some of the mulch.
Okay. I think this is one of my best places for the mulch. This was our spring bulb bed or summer bulb bed where we put in all of our lilies, and sure enough, the not cactuses, pricklers, thistles were coming back. And after digging them all out again, we laid down and marking where each of the lilies were, because some of them are still coming up, some of them have been nibbled off. After we had them all marked, we were able to put mulch in between them all and put it here against the driveway, so it looks, or the street, so it looks nice. Peonies shows them off really well, and I love it that the weeds aren't going to be here. Now and then the same over here. We had been overrun by daisies. As much as I like daisies, they were taking over. You could not even see the lilies that were in here. So we pulled all the daisy plants out that had planted themselves, spread that with mulch, took out the grass that was in there, and also did the other side of the driveway, so it looks nice and it looks clean. Helps control those weeds. Keeps the moisture in the ground for the plants that we do want. And again, the same thing along here. And there's the famous daisies that try to take over every year.
It's amazing how they self-seed themselves. I mean, to say we had 100s or 10s of thousands of daisies would probably be an underestimation.
Right, and they all started with a one package of seeds one year, and we've had them ever since. And we've given them away, and we've cut them off to prevent the seeds from coming from their heads, and they still do it.
Well, I noticed you even added some mulch over here against the new iris bed.
Yes. That too, you know, when you leave any bare soil open, you're inviting weeds to come in. So keeping it away from the iris so that their roots are not covered makes a nice edging and makes it look pretty.
So you want me to flag down a couple more truckloads?
Sure, honey. Well, about a total of 6 hours, four yesterday, two today. We finally got all the mulch moved around. The gnats are trying to bite me again. And it was a pleasure to see that truck pull in because we really, really needed more mulch to get rid of all those weeds that we had to deal with last year because the mulch had grown, well, it had decomposed into the soil like it's supposed to. So, kind of tired right now.
I'm pooped.
And these gnats are getting me. If you learned something or found this interesting or helpful, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear your comments and tips and questions. And we'd also love to have you subscribe and be part of our garden family.
And don't be shy to ask people when they're cutting down trees in your neighborhood for free mulch.
Definitely, because it helps them. They don't have to travel
miles
and miles to dump it and then come back. The guys today as they drove by said, thanks for helping us out and taking these loads. So
don't be embarrassed or think you're causing an imposition by asking.
Nope.
Oftentimes you're really helping them out.
Yep. So bye for now.
Well, you want to start all over?
No.